If you want to turn on the light, you just have to switch it on. But have you ever wondered how these traffic lights are switched on and off? Here, manual switching is not possible. So, what is the concept behind it? The main hero behind this is a relay. A relay is an electrically operated switch. To know more about this, continue watching. Hi, this is Benila. I make videos based on electrical and electronics concepts. If you're into this, consider subscribing. Relays are electrically operated switches that open and close the circuits by receiving the signals from outside source. For example, when you press the power button on your TV remote, it sends an electrical signal to the relay inside the TV, which turns the main power on. Do you know how this relay turns on the TV? To get a clear idea about this, let's see the construction and operation of a relay. First, let's see about electromechanical relay. When a current flows through a conductor, it produces magnetic field. Bending a conductor into multiple closely spaced loops to form a coil enhances this effect. The strength of the magnetic field can be increased by placing a magnetic core of ferromagnetic material. Now, what actually happens here? The presence of magnetic field makes it act as a magnet. Now this conductor acts temporarily as a magnet. Why do I use the word temporarily? Because when no current flows through the conductor, it loses the magnetic properties. This is the basic principle behind the electromechanical relay. A simple electromechanical relay consists of a coil of wire wrapped around a soft iron core which acts as a magnet when current flows through it. Above a coil, a movable iron armature is present. The armature is held in place by a spring. When an electric current is passed through a coil, or in other words, when the coil is energized, it attracts the armature. And when the coil is de-energized, the armature returns back to its position. A movable contact is connected to the armature. When the armature is attracted towards the coil, this movable contact either closes or opens the circuit. This kind of contact which closes the circuit when the relay is activated is called normally open contact, and this one which opens the circuit when the relay is activated is called normally closed contact. Now let's see about solid state relays. In solid state relays, instead of coil, a light source is used. It can be a LED or an infrared. Similarly, instead of armature, a phototransistor is used. A phototransistor is a device that converts light energy into electrical energy. When a relay receives a signal, a LED is turned on. This light will energize the phototransistor and so it will allow the current to flow through it. Here, the circuit is turned on and off simply by switching on and off the LED. Now, if you see clearly, you can understand that both electromechanical relay and solid state relays serves the same function. The decision to use electromechanical or solid state relays depends on the application's electrical requirement, cost constraints, and life expectancy. Although solid state relays have become very popular, electromechanical relays remain common. Many of the functions performed by the heavy-duty equipments need switching capabilities of electromechanical relays. Now, let me ask you one thing. What is the input to the relay? It can be anything. It can be a switch, or a sensor, or a timer, or an output from a microcontroller. Now, let's see few applications where relays are used. Humidity plays a major role in the growth of mushrooms. A high level humidity anywhere from 80 to 100% is required to minimize the drying. So, whenever the humidity goes below this range, a relay is used to switch on the humidifier. Relays don't always turn things on. Sometimes they are very helpfully turn things off instead. In power plant equipment and electricity transmission lines, you'll find protective relays that trip when fault occurs to prevent damage from the things like current surges. Relays can drive multiple output with only one input. For example, security system in shops can be designed so that when a thief tries to break into the shop, suddenly warning light and the alarm sound turns on. Time delay relays are useful in any situation that requires components to be powered for a set length of time. For example, in amusement park rides, these relays can be used to power devices for set interval. Relays have almost unlimited uses in automotive application. Few examples where relays are used in cars are gas valves, headlights, windshield wipers, interior lighting, alarm systems, etc. Even when an application doesn't specifically require a relay, using one can improve beneficial because it reduces the need for high amperage wiring and switches, which are expensive and take up space. If you're interested in this kind of video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so that you'll be notified each time I upload a video.